For most people, this might be your last kind of normal weekend for a long time. And I know this will be the last official Friday night that's not involving high school football. But it does actually involve high school football for a lot of people. And joining me here in the studios, we got some of the guys from the Jackson Ironmen football program. We got three of the captains with us. So guys, go ahead and introduce yourself this morning. Step up to the mic and tell us who you are.
I'm Cade Wolford.
Drew Wiley.
And Eli Broman.
Awesome. So you guys are excited. You guys have been working hard since, well, there's never an off day, I know that, but officially underway since the last part of last month and into this month. You've had all your big practices, your 2 days and all that kind of stuff, and now in the midst of preparing. So what have you guys been doing to get ready for this season?
Well, obviously we got our off-season weight program, which starts about a month after the last season ended. So the whole school year, you know, we got up about 6:30 in the morning, got a good lift in. And then once the summer started, you know, we were installing everything we need to install and just really getting the season underway. So
awesome. And, of course, been running kind of through some walkthroughs and all that kind of stuff. Got some scrimmages and everything coming up, and the season officially kicks off next week. So what's been the main focus this year? I know each year there's kind of a theme or kind of an overall thing that you're really kind of focusing on. What's been the goal so far this year? Got anything specific in mind? Besides winning.
Really just getting to that game that no Jackson team has ever been to, you know, win the region and then going to the state after that, and really just taking it one game at a time.
Awesome. That's what you guys are doing. You've already been kind of working through things. You had a scrimmage last weekend and another scrimmage coming up tonight, I do believe. So what can we expect with that? So what we got on the agenda? So
We got Bellbrook out of Dayton today. They're going to be a good team. We've played for the last 2 years, and it's been good games. So today we're just expecting to come out and see what we got.
Now, come on, hold a minute. Now, scrimmages are supposed to kind of be like a bunch of people getting together and not really, you know, just kind of tossing the ball around. Nobody, you know, fighting hard to win or anything. You're not supposed to be playing against a team from Dayton that's a tough team that you guys have played every. So these guys, I mean, you guys aren't wasting any time getting ready for this season. You want to make sure that you're ready. I mean, because Bellbrook's a great team, and I know you always hear the name come across postseason, that type of stuff. I'm proud of you guys for doing that. I know that not that there's ever a downtime for you guys, but proud of you guys for putting in the effort and facing a team like Bellbrook to start out. Because, you know, a lot of, like I said, most of the time you think scrimmage, oh, it's going to be an easy thing, but this is not going to be an easy one, is it?
Yeah, it's very important for us to get some hard tests early on so that when we get to the big games like Ironton, Wheelersburg in the season, you know, we've already been battle tested. So
yeah, and you guys don't really have a very much of an easy schedule. I mean, a lot of times the joke has always been, the first couple weeks, those are kind of throwaway games. But oh no, not for you guys. You guys run heavy from the start of the season and then right into conference. Is there ever a downtime for y'all?
No. So we've beefed up our schedule like this because that's what it's going to take to get to the next level to, you know, win the region and ultimately get to the state.
Absolutely. And just real quick before we switch over to talk to Coach Hall for a couple minutes, you guys, of course, you know, most of you guys have been playing together through years from the, you know, for the Pee Wee program with the sideliners, that type of stuff. What advice do you have as captains now of the high school team? What advice do you want to offer to those younger kids that are coming up through the Pee Wee program and into middle school and all the way up to high school?
Just stick at it. Just keep working hard, you know, every day. Just make sure you're outworking everybody else and keep at the game.
Really just work hard and cherish everything because it's going to go quick.
Yeah, it really does. It really does. And, Coach, you got some great guys. I know you're just getting things started. So was this fifth year? What is this year for you here? So
year 15.
I thought it was coming up on 15 years. Right. So, man, it doesn't seem possible. So, well, looking forward to another great season. And what are your thoughts as we head into the start of the year? So,
well, I'll tell you what. You know, we got to replace 18 starters. So it's been exciting in the off season to watch these young kids grow. You know, like Kay just said, you know, our season starts for the next year 30 days after the last game. So we don't spend a lot of time doing nothing. So, you know, the 4 days a week in the winter and spring, in the morning and afternoon, gets us ready for our summer workouts. And in the summer, we're 3 days a week, you know, installing, like he said, and working out and getting ourselves ready to go. And, you know, it's been interesting to see this young team grow. You know, these 13 seniors who all have been in the fire before, they understand the struggle that it takes to be successful. You know, they need to install that wisdom and knowledge and understanding to these young kids that, hey, this is what it's going to take for us to reach that bar we talk about, but then, you know, do things that, you know, Jackson Ironmen have never done before, and that's to jump the bar and get into the regional championship and on. So, you know, it's kind of interesting as a coach to see this transformation, and these guys have really busted their tails this summer, and I understand that they've got some goals they want to achieve, and they're working towards it.
Absolutely. And, of course, things official. Like I said, we got the scrimmage tonight against Bellbrook at home. What time does that start?
We start at 6:30 at Alumni Stadium. Last week we played Ashland Paul Blazer High School out of Kentucky.
another big school.
Yeah, they won a state title 2 years ago. Last year they were in a state semifinal. So, like you said earlier, we don't – you know, it doesn't ease into anything.
No, there's nothing about it. So.
You know, Dayton Bellbrook's won the regional the last couple of years as well, and they're Division III in our area. So we get a good test tonight, and then we open up the season next week at home. Be senior night. We're going to honor our seniors, but introduce our seniors to the the community and our band, cheerleaders, and football team. Against Logan, an old SEOL rival.
Absolutely.
It's always a great battle against those guys, and then that will kick off the season. And that'll be a 7:30 start.
And then, of course, right after that, you go on into Ironton, I think it's week two. And,
right.
And that one's going to be kind of an exciting time as well because they've actually shifted that to a Saturday evening game. And it's part of a whole day worth of activities, I think, happening. Some other games happening that day, too.
Right. So. It's called the Ironton Classic. There's going to be three games. One ticket will get you into all three games.
Awesome.
We play the 8 o'clock game. But it's a chance for these guys to be on a nationally televised
it's wild.
Situation. There'll be vendors there. It's going to be a lot of tailgating. I mean, it's going to be a college atmosphere.
Oh, yeah.
So it's a chance for us to kind of upgrade that situation, give the kids an experience that most high school kids don't. So that's, of course, a big game. Of course, then we come back with Wootersburg at home. We all know what that's about.
Right.
And then Western Brown on the road. And then we play Hamilton Ross this year, a Division II team,
okay,
who has been a regional powerhouse out of Cincinnati in week five at home before we start getting into the gauntlet of the FAC.
So never a downtime. Well, guys, we are looking forward to an exciting season for y'all. Now, something else that's coming up this weekend that is going to maybe be a little bit less stressful, if you will, and maybe a lot of fun. I know it's a big event every year. The Sideliners have the annual Jim Humphreys Memorial Car Show coming up this weekend. Tell us about that.
Well, I tell you, it's a great event. We moved it up to Alumni Stadium a few years ago, which has been awesome. Kind of these car owners love to have their cars in good places, so now we have a place for them. The Mothers Club have a concession stand, so we'll use the stadium for that. Our kids will help work it. To help help these guys. But again, it's a great fundraiser, but it's also a nice afternoon to come out and look at some beautiful cars from all around, really three or four states that come in for this. We're going to kick it off around 10 o'clock. I think it's around 10 to 2. So come on out and we'll have some great food and great entertainment. A lot of times, there's music there as well, and just a chance to visit. I grew up, my dad was a big car dealer back in the day. He used to have old cars, so my sister and I would go out with him on weekends with my mom and go to these car shows. So this is something I always liked as a kid. So again, a good chance for the community to come out and support this thing and just get out to see some beautiful cars and enjoy the atmosphere, enjoy the day.
Awesome. Well, hey, we are looking forward to a great season. As we've already said, keep up the great work, guys. We're looking forward to cheering you on and encourage you. If you haven't got your tickets yet, tickets on sale now for all those games and those reserve seats and everything open to the public now. So purchase your tickets. Let's get out and cheer the Ironmen on to another great season. And guys, looking forward to it. Stay healthy, stay strong. And fight hard, and we're looking forward to a great season. Thanks for coming in this morning.
Yes, sir. Thanks for having us.
Thanks.
All right, lots more coming up on